February coming up, you know, it's a big month, Black History Month. I know this means a lot to us, means a lot to our teammates, like who we grew up with. So how do you guys feel about kind of educating others and kind of putting that out there for more for people to see?
It shouldn't be this month, but we just talk about Black history. We should be talking about that this month, next month, the month after that. Like, I just feel like that's important because it's a lot of things to know. A lot of things to learn about Black history that we don't even know about, that we didn't even learn in school coming up. So
even going back in Nigeria, we had to learn about American Black history and the history of slavery, everything. I feel like when I got here, it got watered down. All you hear is Abraham Lincoln, free the slaves, MLK gave his speech, Rosa Parks sat in the bus. They don't even know that Abraham Lincoln didn't want to free us. It's just stuff like that. I feel like we have to get more in tune with our history, and I feel like it keeps us in touch, and I feel like it can connect us, and we can know where we're actually from. It should be something that should be taught to everybody like around, so we actually know what we're going through.
Yeah, so, I mean, look at the school we kind of go at. I mean, here at the University of Florida, which is successful academically, athletically, kind of all phases, top five public school in the entire nation, and only 6% is Black. Because I bet you if you ask anyone on campus, you know, what kind of percentages would you think the Black like go to University of Florida, I guarantee you nobody would know. We'd have no idea. Yeah. And like most people just don't know that. So when you say, hey, it's 6%, it'd be like, wow, like that's crazy. I would have never thought that that was something that's real. I mean, and pretty much 95% of that's all athletes. Nobody really knows that. So, you know, the history goes so far back, all the way to the Gator Bay chant back in the day. There, I mean, there's so many different things that people don't know. And I feel like that if that was brought up, obviously in the month of February, but awareness throughout the whole year. I mean, there's so many things that we could learn about and gain that could kind of boost our communities to kind of help that as an overall topic and subject.
I think that's a great perspective. Like us as Black athletes, obviously we get the spotlight, but like you said, like we have students here, that, Black students here that are doing great things outside of sports. And like I said, it's something that's undermined in our society. Black students at PWIs, like they get undermined. They don't get the same spotlight we get.
We only see Black kids at PWIs like an athlete point of view. I feel like there's more to just than being an athlete. College is not just about being an athlete. Life is not just about being an athlete, because this ends somewhere. And you still have to have a life after that. And I feel like it's really important that we show that too to the other Black kids on campus.
Being in February, I feel like it does give us that voice. You know, because I mean, obviously that is something that is very profound in this nation and in the month of February. That's something that you recognize. So I feel like this is kind of our opportunity to put that out there, and it starts in a small place like University of Florida. And being an athlete kind of gives us the voice, right? Yeah. But you shouldn't have to be an athlete to have a voice. Right. I feel like if, you know, we reach out to BSU and the Black Student Council, we're able to kind of connect with them, and you know, if they came to our games and we were able to kind of share more of a connection with them, reach out with other certain communities here and there, and you know, move together, move as one, kind of like be
it's
more,
power in numbers.
I feel power in numbers. Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, and that would kind of help boost that 6%. People would feel more welcomed here, and you know, more, not just Black athletes, but Black students would want to apply to the University of Florida. Yeah. So I feel like if we were able to move together as one, you know, there'd be more attendance at certain events and athletic games. I feel like that would be a way that we could kind of more come together to do that.
And just to establish a sense of unity, because like I said, there's a big disconnect between Black students and Black student athletes. Being at my previous school, Iowa State, I seen that, and I'm pretty sure you guys seen that here as well. So I feel like that would be great.